Hello everyone and welcome to this new video. I know, I promised that the next video was going to be episode 3 of Learning Sorani, and it is on its way. The episode will be a little bit longer than previous learning videos, and that's why it's taking some time. Bear with me and you will get that video in the near future. If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the like button and comment your opinion down below. As usual, don't forget to send your donation to our PayPal account. Once we reach a minimum point of income, we split the total amount, sending 50% to charity, for now charity organizations in Rojava, while the rest 50% goes to funding this channel, its website and other things helping us to survive. More information will be in the description box below. Now, without further ado, let's get into what's going on in Rojhelat and Iran.
Kermanshah, Kermanshah, Meydan-ı Azadi.
In the 16th of November 2019, big demonstrations broke out in Rojhelat, which is the Iranian occupied part of Kurdistan. The demonstration itself were an effect of other demonstrations breaking out in different parts of Iran the previous days. Thousands of protesters, both Kurdish in Rojhelat and from the Persian people in other parts of Iran, gathered to protest against the increasing prices of petrol in Iran, which had increased by at least 50%. This increasement is, according to the regime of Iran, an essential act after America's economic sanctions towards the country. However, even though the Iranian regime easily wants to blame America, and even though America is a part of the issue, there is more of the truth. The Iranian people are tired of how the regime is handling the country's economics overall, and the increasement of petrol just happened without anyone warning about it. Simultaneously, the leader of Iran, Ayatollah Ali Khamenei, denied the will of the demonstrations, saying that these demonstrations are being performed by crazy people, not the Iranian people. The demonstrations of Iran has today spread across a lot of large cities in the country. Some people are blocking the roads, abandoning the vehicles on highways, while others are setting banks and stores on fire. The Iranian regime has answered to the protest with a total internet shutdown in the country, hoping to silence the demonstration as much as possible. While civilian protesters has been killed by the regime has also lost some people, not at least reports of security forces outside of Tehran being stabbed or the several regime security officials killing Kurds in Rojhelat, which later on faced the same fate, being killed by Kurdish protesters. The Amnesty International reported on Tuesday saying that at least 106 people had been killed in the violence between protesters and the regime. And while the protests continue even today, the regime has made it clear that they won't back down on causes regarding the survival of the Islamic Republic of Iran. The Kurdish people of Rojhelat is facing a lot of atrocities at the moment. It is reported that 11 people died in Mariwan, 9 in Juanro, 5 in Kermanshah and 1 in Sina. Approximately 45 of the Kurdish minority in Iran has been killed and over 500 has been injured, while the Iranian regime has imprisoned over 300 Kurdish protesters in cities like Kermanshah, Bokan, Mariwan and Juanro. And while the protests are spread around the whole country of Iran, the regime of Iran is really trying to shut down minorities to be able to focus on their own Persian majority, hereby clearly putting Kurdish cities under siege and warning the family of the martyred people to be silent. Don't forget to comment down below what your opinion about this is. And as we said in the beginning of this video, this conflict has just broken out, so it is possible that we will make another video of the situation in Rojhelat and in Iran. Just hit the like button and show us that you want that second part, and we will provide it in the future. Until then, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and we will see you next time.